talk about shadows, we do talk about light and the light source. So let's assume we have a cube in front of us and the light is falling from top. Okay. So when the light falls from top, the shadow exactly falls below the cube. And as we take this light source, the shadow changes. At 45 degree, the height of the object and the shadow is almost the same. And as the source goes down, the shadow increases. In our previous video, we have already understood the logic. Okay, so here what I'm going to do is I'm going to just sketch the shadow and we will see what happens at each angle. So I have drawn a simple cube at 2-point perspective and I have taken a light source over here. So when you want to draw technically, you can actually consider this top surface as a surface with which you have to, you know, take the angle. So I'm taking this side and I'm taking, considering the angle to be 30 degrees from here. So you can actually draw upwards from here and decide where your source would be. Okay, so here I have taken the source and we all know that from this source, from the top, what we have to do is draw a line that passes through the top, and from the bottom of the source draw a line that passes through the, so if we take top of this, we have to take the bottom of this. Okay, then again from here, from the top, extend this line further, and from the bottom, okay, so wherever they meet, and same with the third side, from the top, so we get the third point over here. Okay, so let's just, I'm going to outline in dark the shadow. So this is going to be our shadow. So at 30 degree the shadow is longer, much longer than the height of the object. Okay, so the second scenario that we are going to look at is what happens at 45 degree. So once again, the same thing I did, I considered this side and consider this as a top surface, and from here approximately, so considering that as a plane and taking a 45 degree angle backwards, and I decided my source of light would be this tall and located somewhere over here. Okay, so I will begin with that line itself.
Shadow pattern at 45.
at 60 degree, again same method, I took an angle and I decided this, that's how tall my source would be. So once again from my source I will start drawing the lines. So at 60 degree, my shadow looks small. Now we are going to look at certain scenarios which will not be possible for us to draw. They exist in real life, but it will be very difficult or next to impossible for us to draw. So let us consider that there is a cube lying like this. So our horizon line is going like this and cube is partly above the horizon line and partly below the horizon line. And source of light is near VP1 and it is almost of the same height of the cube. So in the beginning, in the video which you saw, we showed you that when the source of the light is of the same height as the object or even lower than the object, then the shadow are actually casted on a wall. So if there was a wall over here, then probably the shadow would be casted on this wall. But over here, let's try to draw. Okay, so when we try to draw from this source, so these lines never seem to intersect. Okay, so the same thing for this. So the lines will never intersect. They will actually intersect or be casted on a vertical surface if there is any. Alright, so this is not possible to draw. Okay, the second scenario which is a little tricky to draw or maybe not a correct way, not possible to draw, is when there is a cube which is lying like this. And the this last line of the cube, the face of the cube, if the source is within that line, then to draw this part becomes a little tricky. So if I attempt to draw it, so I get these two points, but I don't know whether where these will merge. So this one is also not very correct. So the source should not be within that cube thing. It should be little away from it. It should be within your VP1, VP2. That is better. And it should be little bit away from what your composition is. Okay, what your shape is. The last scenario that we will talk about, which is very difficult to draw or fit into your paper, is when the source is very far. So consider this cuboid that we have drawn, and consider the source is pretty far. Okay, so when we start drawing, these lines also never seem to intersect. Okay, so this is happening because this one also, it's like the source is very far and we see that the shadow eventually fades out, so we never get like a clear outline. Okay, so in this scenario also it is not possible. Now these are technical drawings which you should actually draw with precision, with instruments, etc. We are using it in the sketch format just to understand the logic. For your examination, for your NATA exam, let us assume that you have a composition which is like this. So you have, in one of the questions that I have asked you in the sciography assignment, is to draw bottles of different shapes and sizes. So you can also put small bottle, tall bottle, and a bottle which is lying horizontal. Okay, so consider that these three cuboids are like bottles. Okay, and VP1, VP2 there. Now, if you start drawing it very technically, it will become too much of a mess. Okay, in exam, you will not get so much of time also, and it will become too much of mess. So, you remember the logic that we had discussed on day 1, that if the object height is X and the source of the light is at 30 degree, then the shadow is very long. Okay? If the object height is X and the source of the light is at 45, then the shadow length is as much as the object. So we are going to use this logic right now over here. Okay? So what we will do is we will start from one of the corners. So assuming the light is falling from, say, left hand, the source of light is somewhere here. Okay, so let's draw a bulb over here. Source of light is somewhere over here, and say it is falling at 45 degrees. 45 is the safest to begin with. Why? Because the height of the object and the length of the shadow is the same. Okay, so now I'm going to use a pencil and start marking. So what you do is, whatever guidelines you have drawn, just extend those guidelines for each object. Okay, so on this guideline, so whatever this height is, just mark. Okay, so this height mark over here, this height mark over here, and join the two. Okay, then again, this height mark from here till here. Okay, again, this height from here mark till here, and join the two. And same for the third one. So whatever height is over here, you mark it over here. Whatever height is over here, mark it over here and join the two. So this is the shadow that we will get if the light source is at 45. The pattern of the shadow will be something like this. Now, if you are given in exam 30 degrees, that means it will be much longer. So something like this will be 30 degrees, and if it is 60 degrees, it will be much shorter. Alright, so in examination, use this technique or use this method to show that you understand the logic of sciography. Okay, now if there are two overlapping objects and all, then the shadow can also fall on the object as well. Okay, so that we will do in other session sometime. But for now, understand this logic and finish your assignment using this logic. Okay?